On the backdrop of shootings that have happened recently in Kampala involving prominent persons such as Minister Charles Engola and prominent vlogger Olaxis, today a moneylender of Indian descent was shot dead at Raja Chambers located on Parliament Avenue in Kampala. According to the spokesperson of Kampala Metropolitan Police, Patrick Onyango, the shooter is a police officer known as Police Constable Ivan Wawidi. He has been servicing two loans since 2020. The first loan was deducted directly from his salary, while the second one was not.
But today when he came back, he asked again the manager the same question, how much are you demanding me? So they told him the amount, and he started arguing, could not believe that that is the amount he's supposed to pay.
Today, he turned up to know the status of debt and only to be told that 2 million shillings, 130,000 was still outstanding. Wawire got incensed and reportedly started arguing, dismissing the figure, claiming it was inflated. From there, he started shooting before taking off.
Shot at the cameras inside there, there is CCTV camera. So when he shot the camera for her, she took off, and everybody who was inside took off. So we still don't know what happened there. We have called our CCTV team to come and try to retrieve the CCTV footage and analyze and see exactly what happened. So the police officer is on the run, but Uganda is very small when you have committed a crime.
After the shooting, PC Wawire, who is now at large, jumped on a boda-boda and rushed to Central Police Station in Kampala, where he abandoned the killer gun and fled. Onyango condemned the actions of the police officer.
Unfortunate incident. That officer of that caliber did what he did. Instead of resolving the thing amicably and seeing a way forward, the way his bank had agreed to buy off this loan, he should have gone that way instead of resorting to what he did.
He noted that although the police force has done everything possible to protect police officers from landing into financial problems with loan sharks, some policemen bypass regulations and dive into multiple borrowing.
The institution only recognizes banks and money lenders that come to the institution, and they are given letters of undertaking. And in that letters of undertaking, it specifies that you are supposed to only deduct a percentage of certain amount of the salary.
The body of the deceased was removed by police and taken to the city mortuary. MPs have condemned increased gun violence in the country and called for better welfare for police officers and armed men.
I think which we need to interrogate and interact with the leadership of the police on how they've been handling these police officers, but also the army in terms of recruitment process. Whom do they recruit? Do they have the background of those people? Do they know where they come from? Do they know what they...
Great Evo, it is so sad. Condolences to Ugandans, condolences to the family of the Asian who has been gunned down by police officer. This call is for serious interest by the police leadership and the armed forces in general to begin improvising and strengthening other sources of borrowing.
But we need to find the root cause. What is happening? What is happening to the men with guns, the men in uniform? We need to find a root cause and then find a solution to it. Otherwise, this is going to happen day in and day out, and before we know it, we are going to lose very many.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.